changed perceptions of the future, don't need to alter the affection that she's been held in the past. From all of us here in Portsmouth, good night.
He was in 1956, and I was playing a small part in The Corner's Green. I think I was on for about 2 seconds. I always remember the smell of the corridors, the smell of the 50s. I was paid £30.
Radio was much more incisive, much more direct. I remember one poignant moment when Tommy Handley was one of the great comedians at the time. It was a Sunday afternoon. This very BBC voice came on and said, Mr. Thomas Handley, comedian, died this afternoon. Very powerful. I love the recording days. That's what I always liked about the BBC. It was a very fast, disciplined process. You had to beat the clock. You had to be very precise in what you were doing. You know, it certainly helped me to become a movie actor. And I like comedy. I like fast, swift comedy. My favourite BBC programme was Only Fools and Horses, one of the best programmes on television. I love comedy.
For BBC Two now, Seamus Heaney tells of the human rights violations against whole populations made refugees in their own countries.
These are people who have been driven from their homes in Kenya. They are known as the internally displaced. They are not refugees in the usual sense because they have not crossed a border into a foreign country. Refugees have rights under international law. The internally displaced do not. No one takes responsibility for them.
Kwa hivyo tulirasimika, tulipona wenzetu wanapigwa, wale walikuwa na shiba mawe. Na jirani yangu mmoja alikuwa mkisii mtoto wake akadugwa na kisu tukapata ripoti ameuawa.
Over 100,000 Kenyans like Josephine Wachira and her 7 children have been forced from their homes in Mombasa by political and ethnic violence. This has been instigated by the government of Daniel Arap Moi in the lead up to this winter's elections to secure land for his supporters. Those who have been uprooted live in churches, makeshift shelters and compounds. 6 years ago, in 1991, when Moi was forced into multi-party elections, he began a campaign of land transfers, illegal occupation and forced land sales in the Rift Valley to ensure votes for his party. 1,500 people died in clashes. 300,000 were displaced, three quarters of them children. Attackers were said to have been paid for each house they burnt down. In the Rift Valley, a United Nations development program was set up to bring about reconciliation and resettlement. It came to an abrupt halt 2 years later after accusations that this UN program had turned a blind eye to continuing human rights violations, ignored police raids on camps, and that in the process, it became an accomplice to ethnic cleansing in Kenya. The internally displaced are to be found all over the world. They are victims of civil wars, famine, communal violence, and gross violations of all human rights. They lack food, shelter, clothing, safety, basic health care, and education. Since the end of the Cold War, Conflicts have driven people in desperation from one end of their country to the other. Their numbers grow all the time. Today, there are said to be 25 to 30 million internally displaced, almost twice as many as there are refugees. 15 million of them are in Africa alone. How they are treated is a matter of luck, politics, and international charity.
The people who are victims of internal displacement are often seen by governments and by other controlling authorities not as our people, so to speak, who need protection and assistance, but as part of the enemy, if not the enemy itself. There is no political will in the international community to establish a new institution of the type that the High Commissioner for Refugees is, nor is there a desire to designate any one organization to assume full responsibility, because it is argued that the task is monumental and beyond the capacity of any one organization.
In the former Yugoslavia, the problem is acute, and again the international community is failing. Up to 1 million people remain internally displaced by a war renowned for its atrocities. People became dispossessed overnight because the borders around them moved. Most of them have been homeless for 5 years. Today, five countries exist where there used to be one. The Dayton Peace Agreement promised to stop the fighting. It also promised Bosnians driven from their homes that they would be able to go back without fear of persecution. In practice, 2 years after the end of the war, very few have been able to do so. Bosnia's economy and infrastructure are in ruins. The UN estimates that up to 3 million landmines lie scattered around the country, making Bosnia one of the most heavily mined areas in the world. The nationalists in power on all sides do not want the displaced to go home. Those who do go back find their houses vandalized, burnt, or occupied by others. Often, the local police condone or encourage these abuses. Bosnian Serbs, Muslims, and Croats have all been subjected to violence. These Croatians lost their home in Serbian territory. Now they have been told to choose an abandoned house in a town taken by the Croatians.
Svjetla ima.
Da.
Lijepo je uređeno, dovoljno je velika. Evo i žileta mi ostavio.
25,000 people disappeared in the war and are unaccounted for. Their relatives are too afraid to go home, while those who carried out mass murder, rape, and ethnic cleansing are still in positions of power and responsibility. Until the peacekeepers actually make it safe for the survivors to go home, until nationalism eases its grip on Bosnia, then the ideal of a single multi-ethnic state will never become reality. In Sri Lanka, the ethnic conflict between the Sinhalese majority and the Tamil minority has displaced 1 million Sri Lankans. They have become refugees in their own land, uprooted not once, but over and over again. The displaced, mostly Tamils, are caught in the crossfire between security forces and Tamil tigers, both of which commit atrocities. At least 250,000 live in government-run camps known as welfare centres. Many of them are sick and destitute. Conditions in these centres are often terrible. People live in vast, windowless, corrugated iron hangars built as stores in World War II. Displaced children seldom go to school because schools have been converted into temporary shelters. Security is precarious, with frequent sudden arrests and disappearances. There are families, for example, where there are no boys or men left. A Sri Lankan military offensive launched in October 1995 has left much of Jaffna in ruins. Many thousands of Tamils fled the fighting and the killing. The government continues to believe in a military victory to a conflict that grows more brutal all the time. The misery of displacement is affecting millions of people who lack specific international protection. As we saw at the beginning of this program, in Kenya, Josephine Wachira's life has been reduced to uncertainty, confusion, and danger.
Katika hali inje sio tunaogopa ije. Ije kuna uoga kwa sababu hata ukienda wewe kujua watu wamejificha wapi na polisi hawezi kuwa mstuni amini huko around all the time. Kwa hivyo huyu mtu anaku hawa raiders wanaweza kutokea wakati wote. Kwa hivyo bado tuna uoga.
If you want to know more about what you can do on behalf of people displaced in their own country, please send a stamped addressed envelope to Human Rights, Human Wrongs, P.O. Box 7, London, W12, 8UD. Or you can ring this number now on 0990-118-833. One day we'll dance on the news. One day we'll sing our freedom. One day we'll laugh in our joy. And we'll die.
You can see that programme again at 10:15 here on BBC Two. In tomorrow's Human Rights, Human Wrongs, Glenys Kinnock considers the impact multinationals have on underdeveloped countries.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are about to see a scoring of murder.
This is the Cat of Chicago.
Greed.
Frankly, I can't tell you how thrilled we are.
Corruption.
It's a vulgar American show, and we want it that way.
All those things we hold near to our hearts.
The show behind the show. Chicago. Movers and Shakers. Saturday at 7:30 on BBC Two. Murray Lachlan Young is famous as the poet who signed a £1.1 million record deal. But what's his work like?
Think of ethereal Christian surf goth blended with psychedelic lesbian swamp rock. Half punk, half pop, half deathcore. Kind of Vegas Britpop, but much, much more. Much, 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 much more. Yeah.
Murray Lachlan Young performs.
It's a solo project.
Vice and Verse, Saturday at 10 on BBC Two.
Fast-track education comes under scrutiny in just one chance in half an hour. Is it really beneficial to children or merely beneficial to the league tables? For BBC Two in the South East now, First Sight reveals major new plans that will radically change the region's emergency services.
Accident in central London. Firefighters cut a man out of his vehicle while paramedics treat him on the spot. These crews have been mobilised separately. Their roles are distinct. It works, but it's not perfect.
We go out sometimes and we come across situations that we're not adequately trained to deal with. And that puts us under a lot of stress. And I've been there, I've been under tubes with people who've jumped. And I get under and I think, Christ, what do I do next?
Jetzt schon los? Kommen die nur mit oder nicht?
Call the emergency services in Berlin and there's a different response. This call is to a building site where a worker has been injured.